and fanging for the bar. I have tried on occasion to do a show and exclude this particular song, but people come up to me afterwards and they say, oh, you didn't do your divorce song, we're disappointed. So I've popped it back in. I try to make it a little different every time, but it is, divorce is mostly a situation that we celebrate. And I've been celebrating my particular divorce for over a decade now. And I couldn't be happier with my decision. And in fact, my ex-husband and I renew our divorce every year. And he's a good mate of mine. And as much as I enjoy, for comedy's sake, playing the part of the bitter ex-wife, he's a good buddy of mine, and he often comes back to the marital home because he needs to and he's got nowhere else to stay. And I've moved 17 times since we're married. But he's more like my brother these days, and he's got other kids and stuff and other divorces and all sorts of things. I was just the first of many. But God bless him. He's a wonderful man, and no, he's not. He's his shotgun. His name's Mick Albeck. I was Beck Albeck for 18 months. He's a great guy, and we're destined to be. I mean, you know, I always give him a bit. Whether it's a corner of my lounge or whatever it is. I mean, you know, this guy is probably the father of my child, so I owe it to him. I owe it to him, and I can't even remember any shenanigans between him and I mean, I do remember he used to toss and turn a lot, so that's probably what happened. That's all I remember about that sort of stuff, but he's a good bloke, as I said, and he always had a soft spot for me. Which was probably the beginning of the end, really. Nevertheless, I sing this song, and I don't have a great memory, but I do remember our first date, and he said, I wasn't really listening, but he said something about being circus-sized. Or something that sounded like that. I can't remember, but I remember the, later on that month, mother. Not night. Circus, so there's no big top, I said. Anyway, this is a song that I wrote. I wrote about our time together. And for those of you who have seen me before and are perhaps a little bit tired of this song, I try to make it a little bit different. I have written another verse for the end of it to tell you where I'm at vis-a-vis this subject now. I'll tell you more about that bit when I get to it. But ladies and gentlemen, if you are in fact celebrating your divorce or thinking about having one, this is for you. Tell him, bitch, I got a wife. mother warned me. When I was 5 or 6, she said that men like him only think with it. Do you think you're brave? Sort of looking around and working out where people are at, what people really think. You, for instance, you can't stand Beccy Cole, can you? Am I right? I can pick him. That's okay. I'm thick-skinned. I've come to know that not everybody likes what I do. I think it's very brave of you to even buy a ticket to come and see me and have to sit there through all of this stuff. But I have written a new verse, as I said. Now, I don't want you to worry about those ones with this verse. Now, this verse, I get you up to date on where I'm at now on this subject, okay? And this verse, I remind you that this song is only rude if your mind takes you there. It's only naughty if you're rhyming. Okay, do you remember that? Okay, and don't worry about those ones, because that happens, okay? Don't worry, kids. Auntie Beggy's talking about Santa. Ooh. I think I might have got a little smile out of you. I thought you were like Teflon, you didn't crack. It's been 10 long years since I traded bad luck for no wonder mad and no wonder fuss and fight with. Someday I'll find a place to lay down my anchor and I'll find a man who's not such a waste of time.
Oh, my God.